Now we enter to the section of people, the second P. The first P was profile. We finished, we created the picture and the profile, and now we're going to people. Once you have your profile, you start thinking about how you connect with others. You need to add people to your profile and that those connections. Usually you begin adding people that you already know, you know, your colleagues, your friends, or things, people that you already know. But the most important part is doing this networking that people you don't know, but you want to know. So you have to think about LinkedIn like a contact management system. You remember those old systems that people ask, take a car? Well, it's something like that, but it's even more profound and more useful. When you go to a networking event, you are able to talk probably with three or four people, right? Most of the time, one of them will be people that you would like to continue the connection. Another two are just nice people. In the case of LinkedIn, it is even more powerful. So now we will enter to talk about three things in LinkedIn related with people. One is groups, the other is skills, and the last one, recommendations. After we have this video, we will go to the computer and I will show you where to navigate and where to find these three things. Okay, let's talk about groups. Because you want to meet new people, you can go to this groups area and then actually talk with them. And what is this groups area? It's people who have similar interests than you or interests that you want to explore. There's a groups directory included in your package that you can go and read all the directory and select the groups that you would like to belong. So what they do, these people in the groups, they discuss different things of the things that they're interested. For example, two or three years ago, I wanted to publish a book. It was my first book, so I was thinking, how can I do it? Do I have to use a publisher or I can do self-publishing? So I joined actually to two groups, one to recommend use a publisher and another who recommends to do self-publishing. And I learned a lot from them. There are people who already were doing the same thing and they have the reasoning for doing one way or another. And I created not only new contacts, I learned from them and I created new friends. So that's the story with the groups. My advice is go to this directory, review it, and join, and start participating. You can post a question, you can answer people's questions. It's kind of mentoring, a peer mentoring. You know, sometimes you be a mentor, or sometimes you mentor somebody. And it's an excellent way to start connecting with people. The second thing I want to talk is about skills. Now, interesting thing is once you put your thing in your profile in LinkedIn start finding the words, the keywords, and LinkedIn lists the skills for you. And people start endorsing you. Oh yeah, I endorse it. So the first time I saw that is a new, probably 2 years already. I said, oh, people that endorse me, that's nice. But then I realized that you really have to guide the software. What skills do you want to be endorsed? What skills you want to have in your profile? You know, so that's this. I will show you how to do it, because it's not like people voting for your skills, but also the skills that you want to show to your employers, the skills that you want to show to your future partners, or any business that you want to do. For example, I am a very good programmer. I don't announce it because that's not a job I would like. I'm not interested in consulting in programming. I'm not interested in having a job in programming. So I will put that as as a most important skills. And I don't want people to vote also in my programming. So what you have to do is you select your 10 skills that you want to show to the world and you list it there. Now, after you list it there, people will vote. If you have skills that people have been voting already, you can review it, and then some of them, if you believe it's not necessary, you delete it. There is a limit of the number of skills. I think it's 20 skills that you can put there. So you rule out irrelevant skills, and you select the order that you want, so you have more control of what you want to look, what you want to show to the world. And remember, skills are one of the most important things that employers and people who are looking for somebody like you are actually reading. Another thing is recommendations. Now, you can actually recommend somebody. If you know the person, that's a good job and you like the activity, you recommend. But you have to be very sincere, because this is not like Facebook liking. This is something more serious. Now, some people can also recommend you If people in your network are really impressed with your profile and your skills, they can recommend you to the other people. This will increase your chance of getting noticed by employers, by future partners, by future associates. And that will increase also the chance to enhance your profile as well. So you see how this connect everything, start connecting with everything. Now, you don't need to have tons of recommendations. You need to do 3 or 4 very good. In the same way, you don't need to start voting for so many skills. As long as you have the 10 best skills, that's what you want. If you want 20, that's fine. Okay, so now we went to the computer and I will show you how to do these 3 things in the screen. So it will be recommendations, skills, and join to a groups. Okay? Okay, so let's discuss now LinkedIn. In this case, we will discuss the groups first. So once you enter here, if you click interest, you will see here groups. That's the way you can contact with people. This is all the groups I have joined. I have 40 groups. You can take a tour and give you an explanation. But suppose you want to add groups, you will go all over here and then you will have a section called Find Group. If you click in Find Group and then you put nursing, for example, let's put nursing, you search and then you have all of these options and then you can join them. And some of them you can see and ask access. So some of them are private and some of them are public. So that will be your choice. Another thing you can do with groups is you can create your own groups. So suppose you are here, and again, I click view more because I'm joined to 40 groups that I participate, and you can create your own group. You put the name of the group, and after you create that, people can sign automatically or people can request to join to you. So that will be another option. Now, the other thing I was talking is about skills. If you go to your profile, you go after summary, you will have skills and endorsements. So this is, for example, skills that people have endorsed me. 99% higher education, curriculum design, etc. Now here you can add an skill, any skill you want to add. You can remove skills. Oh no, I don't want this one. You can click here, it's not necessary. And then just click remove it. And also you can reorganize skills. So that's when you're the part that you do all these changes in the skills. My advice is to, don't forget to save. You see, drag to reorder, you can reorder. I want this here. This is not necessary, etc. And then you can save it once you have everything already. So the skills have to be something that you really want to show to the world. You also have, if you don't have any volunteer activity, there is an option. If you click here at volunteer, they will try to give you ideas where to volunteer. Okay? And this last part, you have the recommendation option that I was mentioning. You can manage this. You can add recommendations. You can ask for a specific activity. Suppose I want to recommend it for my work as a director, or I want somebody to recommend me for my work as a chair. I can go here and then find the person I would like to recommend. This person to send me a recommendation and ask it to be recommended. Okay, so I think that would be fun. Enjoy your navigating in LinkedIn and see you next in the next video.